Dear children, we will continue with our chapter 5, weather and climate. Weather is indicated by elements like temperature, moisture, precipitation, winds and pressure. Today we will learn about temperature. The degree of hotness or coldness of atmosphere is known as temperature. The temperature of atmosphere changes through the day. Have you noticed, children, that the temperature of day is different from that of night? It also changes in the course of a year, giving rise to the seasons. Temperature is one of the most important elements of climate, as it determines how hot or cold a place is. Temperature is recorded in the shade in a Stevenson's screen. It records highest and lowest temperature in 24 hours. It is recorded in degrees centigrade or Celsius or Fahrenheit. The sun is the main source of heat on the earth, but the amount of heat which reaches us from the surface of the sun is very little. The heat we receive on earth is known as solar radiation or insolation. All parts of the earth do not get the same amount of heat. Temperature changes from place to place and from time to time. The main factors responsible for influencing temperature on the earth are latitude, altitude, distance from the sea, and prevailing winds, urbanization and vegetation. First, latitude. The higher the latitude, the lower the temperature. The amount of heat is the greatest near the equator and starts decreasing as we move away from the equator towards the poles. That is why poles are covered with snow. The reason is that the places near the equator receive vertical rays of the sun. Next, altitude. The higher the altitude, the lower will be the temperature. We feel cooler on the mountains. Since air is less dense on the mountains, solar radiation cannot be easily trapped. Temperature decreases at the rate of 1 degree centigrade with every 166 meters of ascent. This is called the lapse rate. Next, vegetation. Trees and plants have a cooling effect on the atmosphere. Therefore, forest areas are cooler. Next, urbanization. The temperature of a place may also vary because of local conditions. For example, the temperature of cities is generally more than that of villages. This is because the steel and concrete of buildings and tarmac roads in the city get easily heated. Due to lack of space in cities, there is shortage of open areas. As a result, the heat is trapped between concrete buildings, making cities much warmer than open villages. Next, distance from water bodies. Areas closer to water bodies, such as lakes and seas, have a cooling effect. That is why coastal areas are cooler. This is because land heats up faster and cools faster than the oceans and seas. Thus, during the day, the water has a cooling effect on land, and during the night, the land is heated by the warm sea. That's all for now. Thank you, children.